Oh, behind, in cave.
Enemy over there.
Two, three. All three. Headshot, 99, down. Double headshot. Oh shit. We need to scope. The other one's low as well.
Good morning, Apex University. My name is Dan and I'll be your coach for today. And today we're looking at a rather lucky gameplay because you have found yourself the holy grail of teammates. You found yourself two good teammates that actually use a microphone and stick together, try to make calls. Now, if you're like me and those are the kinds of teammates you like, I'll leave my personal Discord linked in the description. There's a lot of us there that play every day. We're always looking for new people to play with and we're just looking to improve and have fun. So nobody cares how good you are. If you're looking for people, that's where you can go. So let's have a look at your actual game and how it went. Your teammate decides to go swamp and you ping the actual house where you're going to land. So far very good. You and your teammates, however, have pinged and landed very far apart. So if one of you ends up getting into an early fight, you might need to disengage and regroup before you continue. In this first house, you only find yourself an RE45 and luckily armor in the second house. I'm not quite sure why you don't pick up the alternator right there. While you don't have a secondary anyway, you may as well. But so far, so good. Your teammate ends up getting into a fight, so you make your way over, but you way overshoot your grapple here. Make sure you know where you're going to land, otherwise use your crouch in the air to kill your momentum so that you land where you have to, because you end up landing on a low ground where you don't intend to land, and it ends up creating a very risky approach where it isn't necessary. You could have held high ground and gotten there much faster, but one misplaced grapple completely ruined your plan of entry. Then, as you move towards the last house and your teammate went down, you know that there is one opponent with an R99, and other than that, you don't know anything about the situation. I don't think you even noticed that the opponent has an R99. Yet you don't decide to stop and look through the window, doorway, or even outside for a second to scout and figure out what the situation is before you run in and take this fight. So you're going in blind and you're just deciding to stand out in the open and shoot. Now you're just basically leaving yourself over to chance. You're hoping that this works out in your favor, rather than checking what the situation is and making a plan accordingly. Even with your teammate down, you should never rush into an early death. Always scout first, then position yourself, and then shoot. Don't run out and shoot, ever. So this is where I would have liked to see you stop and scout a bit more, that way you could have figured out where the enemies are, and then you could have found a better position based on that information, taken some cover from the window, the shed on the right, or the little shed you end up fighting behind. But I would like you to not run out in the open and start the fight by just standing there and taking anything that is thrown at you. Then as we move on in this fight, when your teammate is fighting the enemies on the left, I would like for you to fight the right side so that both corners that they can push from are covered and you've got this interesting crossfire going on, making it difficult for the enemies to survive or to heal. And I would like for you to wait with your res, because the revive here is way too risky with how close the enemies are. They can get to you too fast, they can hear you, you don't know which side they're going to be pushing from. It ends up working out, but that's more due to luck than due to it being a good play. On the reload here, I like that you're close to the corner, but then as you go back to shoot, you way overexpose yourself to two opponents and a good grenade to prevent them from pushing through the house. But now you and your teammate are fighting on the same side, so if you lost the value from that crossfire, and you're rezzing here while there's still an enemy up, clearly isn't safe here. Luckily, your teammate cleans up, and right after the fight, what is questionable to me here is that you seem to ignore both the loot from the fight and the fact that you've taken some damage. I don't know why you're just continuing to run back into swamps here. You only have an RE45 with 35 bullets in total, so you really should be looting for a second weapon here. And in general, you want to full heal after a fight before you run into potentially another team. Although it is a viable strategy to get into a safe position first, completely ignoring your damaged armor until you happen to run into a fresh one before the next fight is not a very solid strategy. Next, as you move on and reach the next building where you hear some enemies, you instantly ping that there are enemies nearby. So far that's very good, but then I don't see you scouting for any information once again. You just keep running around in the house while clearly these enemies were close enough to hear you as well now, and you're just ignoring it, which doesn't really make sense to me. You want to know where they are, you want to be ready for them. Right now you're just allowing them the time and information they need to engage upon you in any way that they see fit, which is obviously not going to be in your favor. Then you decide to heal up right here while you did not hear the Pathfinder drop down. He's also a Pathfinder, he can get back up, and the door has been blown out by the previous grenade he threw to engage. So overall this is a very risky position, and I definitely would look at your positioning. Your positioning so far has been non-existent. You're just running out towards where enemies are, shooting as soon as you see them. So follow those steps, scout, position, then shoot. Before you shoot, always scout and position first. Two other things based on the game so far that I would like to point out is, first of all, when you end up in a fight with the Pathfinder, your first instinct is to crouch and once again out in the open. Now if you crouched a little bit further to the right, at least you would have had half cover from the little ledge you have in front of you. But in general, in a fight, you never want to crouch out in the open, and you never want to crouch for more than a split second, because it makes you slower and way easier to hit. Cover should be your go-to, and if you don't have cover, then you should be strafing, that is, constantly moving from left to right. Moving on from that, you're also consistently running with two light weapons. You end up walking out of swamp with an R301 and an R99. A very strong combination, but they need pretty much the same attachments, so if you pick them up early game like this, you're going to be looking for all of these attachments twice. On top of that, you have been carrying around a purple heavy mag since the start of the game. You've had various opportunities to take a heavy secondary, and then you wouldn't have the ammo issue you have right now of having only 104 light ammo. Now anybody that uses the R99 or the R301 frequently will tell you that 100 light ammo is not that much for this build. I've got very good aim, and against a team with bad positioning, I'm pretty sure that with 104 ammo I can probably wipe the team, but if they have good armor, they revive or they heal or they have some decent positioning, doesn't matter how good your aim it is, it's simply not going to be enough. So you really want to set yourself up for success here, and so far it seems like you've got these comfort picks that you're looking for. You didn't even pick up any of the other alternatives along the way, even when you didn't have a second weapon. And right now we also see you skipping a triple take, which has 20 energy ammo next to it and 5 in the clip. That's 25 shots, that is way more than one clip in your R301 or R99 is going to do for you. So I would heavily recommend picking that up just so that you have enough ammo in case you get into another fight. You're also running really far ahead of your team all of the time, so you're really likely to be the first person that gets into an engage, but you don't really seem ready for it. I don't see you looking around enough to see if this place has been looted or if there's any possible enemy, and I don't see you setting yourself up for any fight that might be coming up. You're just running in, and that's why you're not ready for these fights. Then we once again see you make the mistake of overshooting your grapple, something you really need to practice, but here is something I wanted to talk about, which is your decision to use your zipline here. And think about this for a second, once you're on top of here, what value does your team have out of this zipline right now? What might happen where the zipline is going to be useful? In my opinion, there isn't any. And this is a mistake that I'm seeing in your gameplay, where you don't really seem to be thinking about or valuing your resources. And everything is a resource. Your cooldown, your health, your weapons, your ammo, your teammates, it's all resources. And they can all be used in various ways. And you have to find such a way that you use them effectively, that you get good results out of them. Those are what we call getting value out of your decisions and getting value out of your plays. And right now you've used the zipline, which you're gonna have to wait 2 minutes to get back, that just doesn't have any value, when you could have waited for 5 seconds for your grapple and used that to get back up, or you could have ran back up normally, or you could practice your grapples and use crouch to kill the momentum so that you didn't have to slide all the way down. Now we're at the start of another fight again, your teammates spotted an enemy, and you're using your R99 from way too far away here. You've got an R301, so you may as well use it when the range is more beneficial to that. But let's talk about the steps that we mentioned earlier that I want you to take at the start of a fight. That is stop, scout, position, and then shoot. Once again, you're running out in the open, shooting first. Once you get shot, you are forced behind cover, cover that you could have taken as a position at the start of a fight, and you would have been in a much better spot to engage. Then when you decide to grapple aggressively towards this enemy, you don't know where his teammates are or what kind of weapons they're running with, so grappling in forward like this when you have no backup and therefore your grapple also being on cooldown, I would say is not ideal. Now there's nothing wrong with committing to an enemy, but you just don't really seem to be aware of all the things that might go wrong, and so try to be a little bit more prepared. Then, after you do some great damage to this enemy, you see him running away around this rock and you just decide to chase him. Now, in general, when you are chasing an enemy like this, they can choose when they stop and engage on you. So once again, that is not in your favor. You need to have a plan. If you just climbed on top of this rock or took the high ground above it, there is nothing they could have done to prevent you from finishing the kill, and you would have also been safe against potential backup from their team. And before we finish up looking at this fight, I just wanted to quickly look at the start again where you shot your R99 to point out that was 12 light bullets right there, and I just wanted to show that to reiterate what weapons you choose early on in the game and why you generally want weapons that serve different purposes or use different ammo types, because that's how quickly you go through already a tenth of your light ammo.
Done.
I'm trying to get my gun out. It's like, no, fuck you.
Oh, what? What?
Where did his body go? Oh! He's right here.
No. I mean, I killed him right here.
Yeah, but I think there was a nade. I know, this is a different person. Where the fuck did this box go?
Dude, what the fuck?
Before we look at the last fight here, I just wanted to say, if you're the type of player just like Nova here that either doesn't have a microphone, isn't able to talk on the mic, or doesn't feel comfortable talking, that's absolutely fine. I'm this kind of player that talks to their random teammates as well, and 9 out of 10 people don't respond, either out of fear of toxicity or just because they don't talk on the mic. But just letting them know that you listen by typing back and responding can already make the game a lot more fun for them and for you, and it can help in the coordination. So do your bit to help end toxicity in the community, and if you get teammates like this, at the very least, just type hi. Alright, so let's have a look at this last fight. You guys find yourself at market and you don't see an enemy team when you show up. However, when you drop down, you do hear a team, or in fact a grapple from another Pathfinder, going to the top of the roof. And instead of stopping and scouting to figure out a position before you shoot, you instantly grapple up and go towards where you hear the enemies. Now, your grapple is on cooldown, you don't know where any of the other enemies are, and you're running in away from the safety of your teammates, and as such, obviously, you die rather quickly. I hope now that we've gone through a couple of these fights and pointed out what the mistake is with just running in and shooting, that you can see here why this ended up so poorly, because it's the exact same thing in the other fights, except this time you didn't find an enemy isolated enough for it to work, and your team get punished for it. So what would I recommend is the one thing that you work on to improve from this point out is, whenever you start a fight, give yourself as much time as you need to assess the situation. In this very last fight, before you grappled up, you could have listened for a split second longer and figured out approximately where they are. You would have figured out, as you did, that all of the enemies are on the right side top of the roof, so at the very least you want to exit towards the left side to be closer to your team and be able to have a more defendable position against these enemies. If you want to flank them, you want to grapple from the outside of the building behind them, rather than straight into them where you have no cover. So giving yourself this little extra time to figure out what is going on and take proper cover accordingly will make a huge difference in how you see your fights play out. I really hope that was helpful. Peace. Interested in me and people that I respected, saying, you know, I like your work.